I'm Barry McDermott, and I know all about rivalry.
What a high one! I'm feeling again. It's on.
McDermott and Fielden.
We know they hate each other.
I had one of the biggest and one of the best, and I absolutely loved it.
There is no love lost between Barry McDermott and Stuart Fielden.
Rivalry, it's about hitting harder, fronting up, standing your ground and never backing down. Anything to defeat the rival and win the battle.
Craven Park, listen to the noise.
That's how you do it. Welcome to Conrad Hall.
Super League Rivals Round. Watch every game live on Sky Sports.
Take your pick or take them all on Sky Sports this Easter. We will bring you all six games from Rivals Round. We'll start with a tense meeting of struggling neighbours Castleford and Wakefield on Maundy Thursday. Blockbuster derbies from Hull and Wigan on Good Friday before yet another doubleheader on Saturday. Sunday then sees Round 8 from the Men's Super League close at Headingley after the women have opened the day and their season with a repeat matchup from last year's Grand Final between Leeds and York. 4 days, seven games, all with a here on Sky Sports. And speaking of rivals, it's a special atmosphere here inside Lee Sports Village tonight for the Battle of the Borough. The Leopards and Warriors will shortly run out in front of a record Super League crowd at this stadium and get round seven of the Betfred Super League underway in some style. Well, it's a chance for promoted Lee to benchmark themselves against one of the competition's best. And they've got a couple of former Warriors in their ranks. Zach Hardacre will take up the right centre position, while on the other side of the field, Josh Charnley's score of 164 tries while at Wigan will look to continue a streak that sees him on 8 for the season so far, and edge ever closer to Danny Maguire's all-time Super League record. Ollie Holmes comes into the starting 13 to replace Joe Shorrocks, recalled from loan by the tonight's visitors, and that provides an opportunity for Ed Chamberlain on the bench. So just the one change to the 17 that beat Hull 24-16. Well, Wigan had an uncomfortable 20-16 round six win over Salford and have made three changes of personnel and a whole lot of movement to their lineup. Top try scorer Liam Marshall is out with an injury, so Lebanese international Abbas Miski comes in for a straight swap. Relatively straightforward in the front row too, as Mike Cooper comes into the starting lineup and the aforementioned Sharks onto the bench. No Brad Singleton. Then the musical chairs. In an effort, you would imagine, to get Field and French on the ball more often, Wigan have dropped Kate Cust, move Jay from fullback to the halves, move Bevan from wing to fullback, push Toby King from centre to wing, and moved Kai Pierce-Paul from the second row into that vacated centre position. Willie Issa is recalled to the pack. Horses for courses, or might that be the best, most effective attack for Wigan with a 1-6-7-9 of Bevan French, Jay Field, Harry Smith, and Sam Powell. A wonderful atmosphere here. A game that Wigan might be under pressure to win, Paul Rowley.
Yeah, I think so. I think obviously they've had a stuttering couple of games this season for the start of the season by their standards, and I can tell you now this ground's absolutely full. The pressure is on them, but the pressure from themselves, I feel, and I think they've the changes they've made have backed that comment up as well.
Wigan won't be looking any further than the next 80 minutes, but their fans may have one eye on Good Friday's game against St Helens.
I reckon their fans, their coaching staff will all have an eye on that. Some of the players that are playing tonight, like Liam Marshall, big parts of the Wigan club, they just got through endurance over Salford last week. I think this is too big an occasion with such a big mashup within their team. I think the nervous energy is going to pull them back tonight, thinking as well about St Helens on the horizon next week.
I think the start for Lee is massive. If Lee can get off to a flyer, I think Wigan are under huge pressure.
What does a flyer look like, Paul Rowley?
A flyer looks like posting some points, whether that be 2 points or 6 points. I think Lee should take everything on offer and nudge the way in front and pile pressure on. Every 2 points is going to pile pressure on Wigan. And it'd be a war of attrition, this one. It'd be a close game.
It's only Lee's fourth ever season in Super League. Of course, they're going up against summer era ever presence in the Wigan Warriors, who have spent every one of the 28 seasons of Super League in the top flight. odds to win the grand final. Understandably, Lee outsiders, their ambitions maybe to creep into a playoff place, but they are certainly impressing everyone. We're going to keep a close eye on Lachlan Lamb and Harry Smith, who is joined in the halves alongside Jay Field for Matt Pete and the Wigan Warriors. Their fans have travelled over here in huge numbers and in expectation, but they are coming in to the Leopards' Den.
Here is rookie Lee Otelli. Lee Leopards are powering forward. Lamb ball over the top. Charlie! John Charlie into the corner.
Well, every time he gets the ball, it's red alert.
Brilliant dummy! What a try for Bevan French! Field and King will score! Wigan hit the front.
Harry Smith's boot is ready. Let's get straight to commentary. Terry O'Connor, Barry McDermott, and good evening, Mark Wilson.
Good evening, Brian. What an atmosphere here at the Lee Sports Village tonight. Liam Moore might well be a busy man this evening. It's the battle of the borough. It's Lee against Wigan. And we are underway, and a roar goes around this ground. And it looks like it is going to be a record crowd, and it's going to be a fiery start. As Lee have first use of the ball, and these big collisions early on are going to be crucial.
Oh, outstanding. Expect a real physical game here. Do you know when you play Saints? It's all about speed, and it is ultra quick. This game, let me tell you, I played in this, one of the most physical games I've ever played in. Lee Centurion certainly get up. They love to get stuck into the near neighbours. And Paul Rowley talking about getting off to a good start. They need the start they had against Hull last week when they scored three tries in the opening 12 minutes. That's the sort of start they're after.
Mark, this is as good as it gets, isn't it, for a weekly round? We've talked about the rivalry and the ferocity of that rivalry, but it's matched in that first set of six. Four defenders meet the big front row, Rob Mulhern, and then Lee Centurions will look to do the same, impose their will on their opposition. Can't wait for this next 80.
Yeah, good defensive set from the Warriors. What can the Leopards do? 40 off the Wigan line. Wigan just working the centre of the field at the moment. Up towards the halfway line. The smoke still lingering around. There might be some more fireworks to come on the field. More good defence from the Leopards. Again, Powell will just work it short, close to the ruck. Last one, they're inside the 40 then, the Warriors. What can they do at the end of this set? They're going to go with a high kick. They're going to test out at the back. And there's a bobble. The ball went backwards, thankfully, for the Leopards.
Oh, well, lucky that Tom Briscoe was just sat in the pocket. And Gareth O'Brien goes up for it. He's under enormous pressure, isn't it? They go down the short side. There's three Wigan chasing, putting the lead fullback under some pressure. I'm just lucky he was there.
Well, Tesla's is changing the halves back, isn't it? Kay Cust isn't there, and Jay Field is giving that role alongside Harry Smith. But the first kick going through the hands and the boots of Harry Smith. I'm really looking forward to watching Edwin Epape play. He was absolutely outstanding last week. In attack, he's lightning quick. In defence, he absolutely smashes them.
Yeah, ripped up the championship last season. There he is, the Papua New Guinea international. And he gets the ball away, and it's kicked downfield, across field. Wigan back inside their own 20, will catch it on the full. There's a slight slip. We had an amazing downpour, didn't we, before the kickoff. But it's eased off now. It's a nice evening here in Lee. Well, for us neutrals watching, it is. I'm not so sure it is in that pack, but...
You know, with Kay Cust not playing as well, lads, I think there's some pressure or some more responsibility on Harry Smith. Jay Field, when he gets the ball, he will be a running threat, linking up with Bevan French. But Harry Smith, Mike Pete knows exactly what he's got in that young man.
Keeping it pretty simple at the moment, Wigan. They managed eventually to get a victory last week over Salford. Now they're looking to put the ball through hands. Here's Farrell, angles back, cuts through. tackled on the 40-metre line.
Didn't he stand up Farrell last week when Wigan got that momentum at the back end of the game for Salford? He was right at the forefront for them.
Here's the high boot from Smith, another tester at the back. Here comes the chase, and in the end it's well taken. Over on the far side by Briscoe, he knew Miski was coming at him, but he did well.
That's it, as soon as he caught it, he could sense Miski coming up. As soon as he pokes the ball, he just tries to drop down to miss that contact. When they kick into the corner, this is the world Wigan said it last week, they like to intimidate, they like to get off the line really, really quick. And both teams here, they're just feeling each other out.
Working their way forward. Pape waits at dummy half. All carried over the 40. That's a carry, big collision centre field. Last one, Pape jumps out of dummy half. Low kick finds the grass. French will try and trap it. He got a nice bounce, and here he brings it back. And the chase all in all, not a bad one.
Well, you look at the way that Willie Iser was getting off the line then. If you look at the numbers which the outside backs and the back rollers do defensively, it's not as much as the men in the middle for the Warriors, because they have got aggressive edge defenders.
They have. Both sides looking to fire in early defensively. Quick to get off the line. This is another short pass. Here goes Farrell. Goyce filled it. Big collision. Knocks the ball free. That pass deemed to have gone backwards.
It's the first one if Apapé, isn't it? Hits a roundabout the ball and dislodges it from Farrell. I love watching this fella play. He's at the back of the play, the ball. Low and hard, both of them. Get a bit of that into you.
Yeah, set restart here as well. Don't hold him in. Perfectly tackle. Legal, just perfectly fair. Tackle. And the first error is a Wigan one. So Lee with the ball just short of halfway now. We'll look to come forward. Byrne leading the Wigan defensive charge here. Pape now pops the ball up short, through the hands they go. Lamb trying to take on this Wigan defence. Pape waits now, flips the ball infield, carried inside the Wigan 30. They're inching closer, the Leopards. Their first real attacking chance. Can they put some points on the board early on here? As it's taken forward, Asiata it is, who's wrapped up 15 away.
Three involvements from him. John Wilkin highlighted him before the game. Give us some good examples of what he does and what a difference he makes for his team.
Martelli just had to wait for the pass, and centre field, he's brought down. Last one, Lamb is looping round to that right-hand side. That's where Pape is going to go now. Here is Reynolds. Little step, gets it out the back. Beautiful movement. Can he get the pass away?
We have a try. Just confirm touchline grounding, please. Chris, if it's not a try, I'm going back for a late tackle penalty on Reynolds.
Okay, on-field try, checking touch and grounding. Briscoe is in possession. He's in the field of play. Can we just run it back? I just want to make sure that he doesn't get anywhere near touch before. Yeah, just that previous angle, please. Yeah, from here, please. Okay, he's in field. Still in field. Okay, we're looking at grounding now. Still in field, and grounds the ball. I'm happy I've viewed the angles. I've made my decision.
There it is, a moment of history for Tom Briscoe, his 200th career try. Dancing down the touchline, and he provides a finish that gets the Lee Leopards off to a flying start in the Battle of the Borough. Great hats as well involved in the back line. It's a wonderful Lee try.
Yeah, an outstanding one. Paul Rowley said before the game they needed to get off to a quick start. And they certainly did that. You look at the ball movement here and the way that their whole players up, Zach Hardacre, Lachlan Lamb comes around. They're catching shadows, some of those Wigan defenders. They're an outstanding team to watch. If you didn't watch them last year in the Championship, they ripped it apart, and they've certainly started the Super League exactly the same.
There's a big collision in that back play, isn't there? I think it's Jake Wardle, right, first time. Hits on suspicion. Derek Beaumont loves what he sees. First points posted. And there could be something else here as
Tom Briscoe, he's celebrating, but there is a Lee player leaving the field at the moment.
I think it's, is it Ben
Reynolds?
Gareth O'Brien,
the fullback. And he doesn't look in a good way, Gareth O'Brien. You're going to see it here. This is the hit here. Oh, wow.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's full-blooded. The ball has gone. And Jake Wardle. Yeah. He might be in trouble there.
Gareth O'Brien will go for a head injury assessment. We hope he will be okay to return, but there's a few worried-looking faces behind the posts at the Wigan end. This is Ben Reynolds. We watched him earlier on. He was kicking them from all over. Can he add one from the sideline here? Really would add to the wonderful try early on. The Leopards in front. That's what he faces, right over on that right-hand side. The Wigan fans are behind the post he's kicking at, so if he misses, they'll probably tell us first of all. Well, he was hitting them in practice, and now he's hitting them in the game. 6 points to nil. Derek Beaumont is worried maybe about the injury to Gareth O'Brien, but he'll be delighted with a 6 points to nil start.
Absolutely. It's a sensational start to the game for the Lee Leopards. There's the late challenge. And it's certainly enough for Gareth O'Brien to take some treatment on the sideline.
Do you know if there's consistency? He's got to go for 10 minutes.
Well, there you go. There is the Simbin for Wardle. You just cannot hit players that late anymore.
We've seen it this year, last year. You hit anyone once they pass the ball, you don't get your timing right, you're 10 minutes in the Simbin. And that's where Jake Wardle will find himself now. So Matty Pete down to 12 men, 6 points behind.
And do you know, for composure for Lee Centurions, there's another big hit comes in. Liam Byrne leading the way. The composure, ultimately, it's Tom Briscoe that does ever so well to get the ball down. There it is, shoulder in, and knocks him back, the big man.
Yeah, Mullen on the end of it. We heard Paul Rowley say earlier on about the importance of Lee just putting points on the board and putting pressure on Wigan. Well, they put them under pressure early on, and their first attack led to the first try, and they're moving the ball now. Another shuddering collision goes in. But Lee almost up to the halfway line. Ipape gets it away. Asiata, short pass. They were almost through again there. Last one. They're going to kick from the Wigan side of the halfway line. Lamb picks his spot. Goes high. Cross to the far side. Wigan happy to take it. Miski moves it to French. But look at the chase from Lee. Brilliant kick chase pressure.
It's amazing, isn't it? What a try does. You know, they just get up, they look really confident, they're giving the set restart away here, but well, they certainly like to defend on that front foot, putting a lot of energy in here now.
Well, 10 minutes on the clock, and it's Lee who have the energy, isn't it? That try has given the confidence, the composure they showed to deliver the passes, execute and score the try has now energised them.
What can Wigan do in response? Down to 12, of course, Wardle in the sin bin. For the first time tonight, a little bit of a hush around the ground. It's been crazy from round about 7 o'clock. That's a great kick downfield, or is it? Oh, it is. What a kick that is. Just what Wigan needed. And Harry Smith has come up with a wonderful piece of skill.
And that's what I was talking about. He'll take that responsibility now upon himself to control and manage these last players, Harry Smith.
Well, another set. And a chance here for Wigan. Farrell will lead the charge. Lee now going to be tested out defensively. Sam Powell looking around. He will get the ball. The Lee defence holds strong. Wigan five away. Cooper trying to power his way over the line. He's met and held. And the referee's going to say, actually, he was held over the line, so go back 10 and play it again.
A bit of wrestle going on there at Asiata, just clamping that ball. There was nowhere Cooper was going to get to the ground with it.
Oh, now here with Smithies. Oh, shuddering from Asiata again. Coming back to the centre of the field. Here now, Field gets it away to French. French puts a little kick through, it's dangerous. And Lee, happy to dive on the ball. To drop out from underneath their own post.
That looks a lot like the play Salford actually put on Wigan last week. Ryan Brierley just dinked a kick through. But it's the first time they've been to our right, isn't it? You can hear the Lee fans getting behind their side as the defender drop out. Ricky Lutella, good enough to get hold of the ball and nullify the threat.
Stay behind, boys. 10 seconds. We mentioned though Kate Cuss, we heard from that bus journey that Jenna Brooks was on, that Custer's got a neck problem. We hope to see him back sooner rather than later, but he unavailable tonight. Bit of a reshuffle for Wigan. French at fullback will be a threat tonight if Wigan can get him the ball. Here they go forward now. Willie Iser making his 300th career appearance. He's tackled 20 metres away. Powell looking around him. He moves it away now to Smith. Smith gets it to Byrne. Byrne tries to run over Ollie Holmes. Now they're coming back towards this right-hand side, and now they've got bodies in motion. Here's French firing, and French with a diving saver. Bevan French slices through. Decisive finish, his seventh of the season. And Bevan French hits straight back for the Wigan Warriors. Back-to-back sets, and the Warriors are on the ball.
Wonderful stuff from Wigan. All came from Harry Smith's 40-20. And then they doubled that up with some pressure. A nice little kick through and a goal line dropout. Here's the 40-20. Judged to absolute perfection. Zach Hardacre at fullback can't get anywhere near it. Wonderful play, beautiful hands, everybody running into space, and Bevan French doing Bevan French. Show, goal, and the deception in the defenders' minds is just too hard to handle. He can't close that space, Lachlan Lab. Return fire for Wigan.
Is it a show and go, or is it a show and gone?
I think he's that quick, isn't he? Players are anticipating what he's going to do before he does it, and that's what players with speed do to you. You're too worried about what he's going to do, you're too worried about him making you look foolish. 7 tries for the season.
Next one will be his 100th career try, and it will take him joint top of the pile. Here's Harry Smith with a kick to level it up. The bad news for Lee fans is that Bevan French has scored in 3 games already this season, and he's scored 2 in all 3. There he is, the man of the moment, Bevan French. This is a big kick for Smith. And crucially, we're going to take in a little bit of time out of that sin binning as well. And that's the Wigan fans you can hear. Matty Pete will be a little bit more relaxed. And there they are, the Wigan fans making plenty of noise. Smith then, 9 in from touch. He'll send the ball towards the post, but he's missed it. Well, goal kicking has been a problem. That wasn't an easy one, but it's one you'd expect him to get.
Yeah, it is. Man, you look at the depth of the last 3 attackers here. Bevan French, the man who gets the ball. People will talk about trying to get a 3-on-3 or a 3-on-2. Well, Wigan are quite happy if they can get a 3-on-3, because that man's got that much speed. He can stand players up and then go on the outside of them.
Ball caught by Wigan. There goes Tom Amone. He got a bit on the last carry. He's getting a bit back now.
They've gone searching, haven't they, for big Liam Byrne, the Irish international. And he's certainly fronted up.
Here's Smithies, wrapped up and thrown to the ground. Wigan working away, now they've got a set restart. Here's Farrell.
Yeah, Kyle O'Donnell, number 24, was just too late, long in that tackle.
It was the strength of Carrizales. Ended up with the back rower on top of him. He fought hard and got his side wing and the advantage. Good work from the Warriors.
Yeah, let's get down to pitch side then. Jenna Brooks has got some news on Gareth O'Brien.
Yeah, the Lee Leopards fullback, I've just been told, has failed his head injury assessment. You saw him there, the look on his face says it all.
Thanks, Jenna. Bad news for O'Brien, who will now have to sit out next week as well. We hope no long-term issue there. So here come Wigan again. Bevan French again. He's wrapped up.
Not a bad replacement, is it, to have Zach Hardacre? Jamie Jones Buchanan, our studio guest, mentioned back in 2015, fullback for the Rhinos, won the Man of Steel. A lot of experience and, of course, a former Warriors player.
Here's a high kick towards the far side. Wigan have got it. Wigan are trying to wrestle their way forward. Abbas Miski's underneath it. He's still trying to get the ball on the ground. Well, that was a great effort from Miski's first appearance of the season and showing exactly why he's been included tonight.
Yeah, strong carry, wasn't it? Good kick. Again, Harry Smith taking control. Drops it just on Miski's head and the power from the winger just to get himself over the line, but some desperate defence from the Leopards.
Two-point ball game, 16 on the clock. Still remember, Wigan have got Jack Wardle in the sin bin. Just under another 2 minutes for him. As Lee look to work the ball out of their own end and they'll carry it forward here. Good carry as well from Mulhern. Here's Epape, gets it away. Two good carries there have got Liam towards the halfway line. Now, work in the middle of the field again. Here's Asiata. Nice one, Epape, 40 metres out. Looking for options. We'll go to Lamb. He's just going to put this one high. He's going to invite King to come and collect it. King will get it, but he's going to be tackled five off his own line.
And again, ending the set pretty well. The Lee Leopards, good footwork from Bevan French, looking for that quick play of the ball now. He did well to recover then, late.
Wigan now trying to throw it around inside their own end of the field. Risky stuff, there is Jade Wardle, got about 30 seconds or so before he can get back out there. There's a ball driven forward by Wigan. One more remaining after this one. Farrell will slice his way up towards the halfway line. They've gone underneath him, but they can't quite get him into touch. But this makes the kick a little bit more tricky. Smith again just sets himself, goes high. That is a steepling high kick. And it's dropped, and it went backwards by Hardacre. And now he'll bring it, and now he's looking to return it with interest. Well, there's Wardle coming back on. We've got 13 against 13.
Well, that's the experience of Zach Hardacre. That ball was swirling all over the place. It just angled his body that if he did fumble it, it would go backwards.
That's a nice carry from Latelli. One of the many new additions in the off-season. Has Chester done a great job putting together this squad here at Lee.
Yeah, hasn't he just?
40 off the line. They go forward now. Oh, spinning. And O'Donnell with him. Couldn't get the pass away. Pape looks. Lamb's come short side here. Last one. They're just going to stab the kick through. King again will pick it up. But Lamb makes the tackle. And Wigan having to bring it off their own line here.
Mark, it was one of the things that Brian Carney talked about before the game. How many people have had to shuffle around to accommodate Jay Field playing in the halves, or one of them, he's putting Toby King on the wing. Obviously, he's a centre by trade, but he's big, he's powerful, his high kick and his retrieval of a high kick will be an asset at the right end of the field, but he loves an offload as well.
There he is, Toby King. Liv Warrington had a spell at Huddersfield, of course, as Field tries to work his way out of a tackle on halfway. He's wrapped up. Powell gets it away to Smith. Smith's going through the hands. Here again is French. French got them backing off, gets the ball out wide. Wigan trying to attack, kick ahead here. Needs to be dealt with, and wow, what on earth happened there? Zach Hardacre went for the karate kick.
Yeah, well, you can see the relief on Zach Hardacre's face. And look, as soon as French gets this ball, the acceleration just worries defenders. Whether you're defending inside him or outside him or just against him, you can see the good kick here from Miski, back in field, pressures Zach Hardacre and Holmes, but he just says, right, had enough of that, get it off the field.
You could see, couldn't you, Zach Hardacre relieved. Eyebrows nearly hit the top of the stand. They went up that high, but when he starts to accelerate, Bevan French, he just makes Ben Reynolds flat-footed. We might see that happen again.
Sure we will. There's a ball carried forward. Nathan Havard into the action now for Wigan. Ball moves along 20 metres out. So both sides, when they've been down the right end of the field, have come up with points. What can Wigan do here? They're getting the ball into the centre of the field. Nice hands there from Smith. Gets it away to Willie Issa. Issa's going to be wrapped up, five short. French steps in at dummy half. Ball now centre field, two field. Drops it back on the angle, little sidestep there. Smithies is going to be wrapped up, eight away. Wigan, loaded numbers left, and that's where they're going now. Looking to get the ball into the hands of Smith. Smith gets it away, big chance here. They're going to score, are they? Did he get it down? What field thinks he's got it down at a second attempt? Referee's going to have a look. He didn't get it down initially, but I think he got it down at the second time. Let's hear.
Brings the ball, Chris, and maintains possession.
Okay, tackle four, try, on-field decision. Field's in possession of the ball. Trying to work out, does the ball get to the ground? All that has to do is touch a blade of grass. Okay, it's up at this point. He's still in possession. Okay, can we run it back there? I think his hand may have come off the ball. But he's still in possession. Can we roll it back, please? If he's still got a grip of it with his arm, it's okay. His hand. Okay, yeah, run it through from here, nice and slow. Okay, yeah, he's always in possession of that ball. And the ball is grounded. I'm happy I viewed the angles, I've made my decision.
Well, Jay Field, if at first you don't succeed, try, try and try again. And he has got that ball down over the line, much to the delight of the Wigan fans. Wigan in front, and their two big superstars, French and Field, have come up with the tries.
And both of the tries are about speed, Andy, the elusive Jay Field. They got the result they were after. Tom Briscoe tried absolutely everything to hold him up. But Matty Pete on those, he knew that he had to handle the fireworks at the start, the pushing and shoving that you're going to get in the game when you play against Lee Leopards. And that man had the composure, the strength to get over the line, show his speed and get rid of Tom Briscoe as well.
Tez, are you happy he still had control of that ball when he puts it down? I think at some point there's a case to say he loses it. Chris Kendall's happy with it. Are you happy with it?
Yes, mate.
Yeah.
There's the kick from out wide. This looks a better effort. This looks a superb effort. That's the type of kicking form that Harry Smith will be chasing tonight. And all of a sudden, the Warriors are 4 points to the good.
Well, you can see, can't you? Everybody moving towards the ball, hips facing the wrong way. He does his best, Tom Briscoe. The ball is on the thigh. I think he lets go of the ball. It stays on his forearm, lodged in between his forearm and his bicep. I think they're unlucky late.
Well, it all came about on the inability to deal with that kick on the last tackle. Now Farrell will look to bring the ball forward. 22 gone in the blink of an eye here at the Lee Sports Village. Bumper crowd, great atmosphere, and the two teams are serving it up as well on the field. Powell gets it away. Field now looking for French. Not much room there. That's the type of environment they want Bevan French to get the ball in. And here's Powell now, skips across the centre field. They're looking to get it back now. They're looking to kick in behind. Smith has turned them around.
That's
and
a beauty.
Chase is on over on the far side. This ball needs to roll dead. And thankfully for Lee, it does roll dead the right side of the corner flag. Seven tackle restart.
The angle just wasn't quite right for Wigan. They kicked on four, recognising that there was acres of space available to them. Best option is to keep it in field. Second best option is to get it over the sideline. It goes behind, which means they now have to defend seven tackles.
Six again, too much.
And they've got a six again.
Straight over the rocks. Zero. Move down. Hold.
Here's Epape. It's the ball into the hands of Asiata. He's wrapped up. And there's Makuwai off the bench. There's a forward just starting to rotate. It's been a hectic start to this game. Here now come the Leopards. Lamb into the line.
He is a key indicator, isn't he, Asiata, where the ball's going.
Yeah. Here's Hardacre. Route one stuff from him. Few boos from the Wigan end. That won't put him off. And Lee are back where they want to be, down the Wigan end of the field. Here is Asiata now to Lamb. Lamb gets it away. Is that going to be a penalty? Yeah, Asiata was hit late.
Yeah, late challenge, isn't it, Kate Evans?
Like I said, he's a big key indicator. He's okay. A big player, and he goes at the line. The powerful forward that he is, you've got to make sure as a defender you're on. Because if you're not, he'll run over the top of you. Got nice subtle hands, but again, hit from the inside.
He's only just late, isn't he? But it's a thunderous challenge on Cade Ellis. You can see he's already made his mind up. The head rocks back. And Wigan would have targeted and identified how important he is for the attack of the Lee Leopards.
Makuwai drives it in. Lee have only had one genuine chance. They came away with points. Can they do the same again here? Epape jumps out of dummy half, gets it to Asiata, who was isolated on that occasion. They're just trying to keep it close to the ruck area. Tackle is made. Mulherm denied.
Lining up on the left here.
They are. Epape sees that, gets it away. Here now is Lachlan Lamb. Thought about the ball over the top. Stabs a kick through, but King is there. King is going to be dragged behind the line. And now the referee has said that they were offside. So it's another penalty here for the Lee Leopards.
It was a bit of panic, wasn't it? Lachlan Lamb, he recognises the way that they're going to jam in out wide. Kai Pearce-Paul comes up, they spot some space at the back. They were offside because they saw the threat unfolding in front of them. The Warriors over on their right-hand side.
They'll drive it forward again. It's fantastic to see ball players like Lamb getting his hands on the ball. Now they're going to go, though, the other way here. Reynolds just pops up the ball to Holmes. So long at Castleford, he's here for a short stint with Warrington. And now Epape will get it short. They're trying to power their way. They wanted it out the back. And it's a knock-on. They've lost it. And Lamb is furious because he knows if that ball goes one more pass, they're in at the corner.
Yeah, exactly. We praised Asiata about it. Taking the ball to line, making the right decision. He tries to go short. Lachlan Lamb was out back. And I think he had probably three or four teammates outside him. He's hit by Willie Ice, loses possession. Cade Ellis lends his way as well.
Well, the noise behind the sticks to our left, the Wigan fans, has just been cranked up to 11 out of 10, getting right behind their side. They know they've just defended one of the onslaughts of the Leopards side, and it's their turn with the ball now.
Let's get down to pitch side there. Jenna Brooks has got some more team information.
Yeah, as you all know, I travelled on the team bus from the DW Stadium to Lee Sports Village. I was also invited into the team meeting before we left. And one of the things Matty Pete warned his players of was the noise here at the Lee Sports Village, the fans. He spoke about the rivalry that goes back many years. He also spoke about the importance of his players being accurate and the importance of accuracy of running lines, and we've already seen examples of that here tonight. He also singled out their dummy half and putting pressure on Edwin Apafe, which I think we've also noticed as well. I just want to go back quickly to Gaz O'Brien, who failed that HIA. Because the incident resulted in a yellow card, Lee do not lose a substitution.
Thanks for that, Jenna. Last one here. As I guess, going to work the ball down the short side. The kick goes in, and it's gathered comfortably by Hardacre. And Terry O'Connor, you know all about playing against Lee and how ferocious it can be.
Yeah, we're talking to Matty Pete earlier, and he said that earlier on in the week he let them watch the 2002 Challenge Cup, the quarter-final, when it was at Hitland Park, where both sides absolutely tore into each other. Craig Smith had come over from Wollongong and had played at Illawarra. After the game, he said, what the hell was that game all about? He'd never played in a game as physical.
He'd never played with anyone like you. That might be what it was. Ball's on the halfway line. Lee trailing by four. Here's Apafe, gets the ball away. Reynolds gets it out to Hardacre. Hardacre with nowhere to go. Wardle wraps him up. Last one.
Release. Goal five.
Pulled out. They go high, but should be time at the back for French to catch this, and he will catch it on the full. The chase is not a bad one. I think Matty Pete, having seen his team go a try down and a man down, will be pretty happy with how they've responded.
Of course, and if you look at both sides, the energy that they've spent in this first 30 minutes is pretty high, but nobody looks like that intensity is ready to drop and see with all these collisions and the line speed from both players, both sets of players.
Here come the Warriors. Taken forwards. And there is a familiar face to those Lee Leopards players. Shorrocks, who played for them last week. Isaac tackled around the waist, last one. Field in at dummy half. Finds Powell. Powell will find Smith. Smith goes through the hands. They've got a chance here. Here's Wardle, stabs a kick through. Hardacre needs to get there, does get there, and he's going to be trapped in goal, and it's going to be another Lee goal line dropper.
Well, good attack, isn't it? You can see Ed Chamberlain just jams in. Space created outside. Jake Wardle, nice kick in field, looking for Bevan French. Just coming up the middle, but Zach Hardacre, all the experience that he's got, was in the right place to defuse the situation.
That's the third goal line dropout that Lee Centurions have had to defend. And you just feel, don't you, 30 minutes, the back end of sets, which was something Matty Pete talked about before the game last week, and then bemoaned after that Salford game. Even though they come away with a win, he wasn't happy with that aspect of his team's performance. Well, they've been much better at the start of this game.
Here come Wigan again, just under 10 to go to the break. Smith gets it away. They're going to carry it forward to the 20-metre line. Apafe is there defensively. Powell, Smith gets it away to field. Bodies in motion again. They break through the line. The pass inside was a wild one. And Lee happy to pounce upon that loose ball.
Well, on the second play again, just rush that play. Whether you can credit Lee Centurions for just getting in front and getting the bodies in front of the man who's carrying the ball and just putting him off. But you know what, considering that it was raining, like you said earlier on, Matt, as we just watched this offload looking for Jay Field, just didn't quite come off. Slippy conditions, you know, the handling from both sides has been pretty good, hasn't it?
It's as if that ball goes out of the back and it hits Bevan French. I think it was 3-on-1. I think Tom Briscoe was in a world of trouble there trying to defend that.
Well, here come Lee trying to put it through the hands. Latelli is wrapped up. Last one. The Leopards struggling for a bit of bite in this last 10 minutes. Hi, this is a swirling kick. This could go anywhere. And oh, it's a risk when you let it bounce. And Abbas Miski delighted it bounced straight into his arms.
Well, it was a shocker to take as well. I think that's the reason why the back three just left it. As soon as it left the boot, it was going everywhere in the air.
It's a shame Lee couldn't get some pressure on them, make someone go for that, because that was difficult. But Wigan are starting to win the territory battle now, and now they've earned themselves a penalty.
I'm working with you.
Two things that just indicate a little bit of fatigue for the Lee Centurions. No chase or a little chase, not enough on that last kick, and they're just cutting a corner and just trying to gain an extra half a step. Adrian Lamb looks on and he knows his side now. Have to defend this next set of six.
25 away from the Lee line. Field pops it up. Ball taken for by Cade Ellis. They'd love an extra try just before the break. The Warriors, and they're in the right place to get it. Another strong carry. Hammond almost went through. Holmes eventually claps the ball and brings him down. Now they're coming back to Smith. Just had to leap and catch it. That might just lose a little bit of traction in this move, but now they're back, moving bodies. Paul back on the angle. Willie Ice is looking for a gap. He'd love a try on his 300th career appearance, but he's denied on this occasion. But Wigan now loading bases left, and that is where they are going. Here is Smith, short pass to Field. Well, the ball bats it down, and Liam Furness had numbers in front of the runners there. They managed to hang on.
Yeah, well, Liam Farrell, he doesn't expect to catch this ball, but you've always got to make sure you expect it. You can see the ball, if it was going to Farrell, it's too hard. It was trying to be a first ball out to Jake Wardle. And unfortunately for Wigan, you can just see, comes off his left hand, goes forward.
I think he'd be disappointed in himself, Liam Farrell, as a coach. Matty Pete looks on. He'd no right to snatch at that ball. There was too much pace on it. As you said, Tez, it was for the player outside him. Sticks her hands out, and there's the knock-on.
It's definitely a threat, though, isn't it? That side of the field for Wigan. Lee happy to survive.
Move! All the 10.
Lee working it forward here. They would give for a penalty now to get them out of this end of the field. As again, Wigan aim up defensively. Pape gets it away. They're struggling, aren't they? They can't get the goal forward they need at the moment.
I thought they might have looked to have kicked a bit early before Bevan French dropped back. No wingers back so far.
Well, here's Lamb, and Lamb gets a short pass away. Last one, that was better. O'Donnell it is, who's wrapped up. Hardacre out, needs to get it away, finds Lamb. Lamb will kick it down the field, but should be picked up, and is picked up comfortably here. French, oh, he thought about offloading that for a second.
He was under a bit of pressure, wasn't he? Ricky Liutelli over the top, looking for that sideline. Surprised both sides, because this pace has been frantic. Neither of them looking for the sideline, just to get a rest and just reassess what the goals are.
I have the feeling there could be a pivotal moment to come in this match as we go inside the last five of the first half. Here's Farrell. Farrell steaming onto it.
That looked forward from Wigan. He's right on the advantage line.
Oh, set restart. Huge moment then. Here come Wigan. Pierce Paul looking to possibly flick the ball away. Here now come the Warriors. Havard takes it in. He's wrapped up, eight away. Lee's pressure intensifies on their own line. They're coming back here to Field. Field, oh, it's an awful pass. Not for the first time tonight, Jay Field's pass.
Well, Jay Field over on the left was a player that threw it, and Liam Farrell made the mistake, and on that occasion, he knows what he wants to do, wants to thread the needle. He's got three options. He thinks, if I float the ball in the path, then one of the players, and the player that thinks the ball is on for them, will grab hold of it, and in the end, nobody does.
So as Lee bring the ball off the line, let's get down to pitch side then. Sean O'Loughlin, the Wigan Warriors assistant, joins us. Sean, you must be happy with the way that the team have responded, having gone a player down and a try down early on.
Yeah, very. It's a tough place to come here and get a win, but tough place to come when you go down early. So it's the battle through that, to come out the other side, posted points while I was down. So yeah, really, really pleased. And just coming to the end of this half now, we're hoping to finish this off. Have a good start to the second as well.
Is the frustration maybe that you've not added to that? You've just had a couple of chances that have gone begging.
Oh, it'd be nice to score more points, but we've put them under a lot of pressure here, and we know we know kind of the tackles they're making, the efforts they're putting in, it'll pay dividends at the end of the game as well.
It's been a furious start to the game, hasn't it? It's been so intense. Is this what you expected coming here?
Yeah. Before the game was classed, there was a great entertainment on, and we expected nothing less. It was going to be physical, it was going to be a bash-up, and I think all the fans expected that as well.
Is this the type of game you miss?
Yeah.
Well, good luck for the rest of the game.
Cheers, thank you.
Cheers.
He's got to let it go sooner or later.
A penalty for Lee. Well, it's a late shot.
Well, it's that inside pressure that anyone who's a ball player in Lee jersey, they're certainly feeling the heat on the inside when they're going at the line and looking to pass.
Well, we mentioned at the other end there could be a pivotal moment. The pass went to ground. Now Lee have got a chance to level up here. A couple of minutes remaining. Epape gets it away here now. Lamb turns the ball. Oh, he took his own man out there. One on the tackle sheet for Lachlan Lamb. More centre field. They'll move it on. Kubowai's wrapped up. Might need a little bit more than that here, the Leopards. Right in front of the post. Epape now goes to that right-hand side. Ball driven in. They're a metre away here, last one. Can they force another repeat set? They're going right here. Are they going to stab the kick through? They're going to get it out wide. They're going for the corner. Wigan defend it. Wigan kick them out. Big test pass.
It's terrific defence, isn't it, from Wigan as we enter the last minute or so of this match. They had to be good. Good communication, you can see. Pointing, moving, and all shuffling across. Mapping across to where the threat is. Not too many questions asked by the Lee Leopards, but nevertheless, great defence from Wigan.
This is a tough end to the first half. What a first half it has been. All the reaction to come.
Free. Moves on. Back now, back. Hold. Goal free.
Wigan just happy to run the clock down here. We'll be happy to get into the visitors' dressing room here. Get some more instruction from Matty Peters. Here's Field now. French into the line. French wrapped up. Good one-on-one tackle. Last one. And they look to kick the ball away here, Wigan. The ball from O'Neill wasn't the best to field. Did well to gather it. Smith is going to stab the kick over the top. They are gambling here. Looking for points. Ball back on the inside. It'll fall eventually. Knocked on by Wigan. Well, that was one out of the playbook. Matt Peake will go into the sheds with his team in front. It wasn't all plain sailing. Tom Briscoe's 200th career try. Putting the Leopards in front. Jake Warnell was sent to the sit bin in that move, but tries from Bevan French and Jay Field mean at half time in the Battle of the Borough. It's the visitors who've got the better of their noisy neighbours at the break. It's Lee 6, Wigan 10.
Mark, thank you very much. The Battle of the Borough has certainly lived up to its billing. A wonderful atmosphere here in front of a record crowd for a Super League match. Matt Peake looks on as the Lee Leopards make their way to the changing rooms for a well-earned break. And Peake will, of course, be grateful to the wonderful Bevan French, his 7th try of the season, getting Wigan off the mark. We'll look at that in depth with Paul Rowley and Jamie Jones-Buchanan after this break.
Here is Reynolds, little step, gets it out the back, beautiful movement, can he get a pass away? They're in! The Leopards are over in the corner! Bodies in motion, here's French flying, and French with a dummy, and it's over! Bevan French slices through, decisive finish, his 7th of the season. Smith gets it away, big chance here, they're going to score, have they? Did he get it down? Field thinks he's got it down at a second attempt.
Well, it had to be that pair, didn't it? Field and French going over for the Wigan Warriors after Tom Briscoe had given the Lee Leopards an early lead here at the Lee Sports Village. Let's get back into the change rooms here, Jamie Jones. The message from Matt Peat in simple form to his players would be...
I'd be getting around the individuals and just reminding them of their roles, their jobs. They've done an excellent job. Harry Smith kicked well. Isaac and Farrell have turned ball back under lead, points through the middle, and that's why their edges can execute as well as they have done.
They might not have to score again to win this game. We know Lee will have to.
Yeah, absolutely, but they're very capable of doing it as well. When they get down there, they look very, very potent. And again, not to bang the drum too much, but Lachlan Lamb, he looks dangerous every time he touches the ball.
We're sitting here in the corner, standing, I should say, in the corner of the field. You've looked back up to the Lee fans congregated behind the goals up there. That is the direction Lee will be playing to. You say it's very important. Why?
It's very important. They're going to play into the north stand. If Lee win the toss every week, that they want to play home, that second half, they want the north stand to bring them home. Don't undervalue, don't underestimate the power of that emotion that North Stand's going to bring.
Are you dipping into pseudoscience here now? Does that really have an effect on the players?
Yes, it does. It does have an effect. It's a powerful emotion. And to be fair, the Wigan end as well, for them boys, will have a mutual effect. But it's a surreal experience. Two absolutely packed ends. And there's going to be... I'm just backing Lee to score more points, definitely.
Well, they're only 4 points behind. So what's the approach to the early stages of this second half? They don't need to chase the game so early in the total 80 minutes, as it were. So what's the message?
Absolutely not. They need to almost replicate what they did in the first half, because they've done nothing wrong. They're doing great. They need a little bit more field position. They will post points, so there's no dramas from a Lee point of view. And I guess we're going to say something similar.
I just wonder, would ill discipline be something that Matt Peat might look at? Jake Wardle was sent to the sin bin. There's an argument for Cade Ellis to go to the sin bin as well for a very late hit. Of course, the referee saw nothing in that, I should say that, but they may have a look at that during the week. Is that an issue for them?
I don't think so. I think Wigan play with a lot of energy and a lot of aggression sometimes. The skill can let you down at times, and when you're playing in high-intensity games like we've seen tonight, it can go the wrong way. But I think Wigan have been really calm, connected, disciplined, and that'll ultimately be what gets them the game.
Now, of course, we know what Wigan have got coming up just down the road. It's a game you'll see with us here on Sky Sports. It's St Helens at the DW Stadium. That is heading for a sellout. And we, of course, have a record crowd here at the Lee Sports Village. Wigan have got a 4-point lead to build on or to preserve. Paul Rowley, Jamie Jones, Buchanan, you know the halftime scoreline. I know who you want to win. Who'll close this one out?
You don't know who I want to win, but I think Lee will steal it.
Yeah, play like tomorrow doesn't exist. Lee get Nick the win today.
Oh, you'd be very popular, you two, here amongst the fans, the mascot, and of course the Lee players. Here they come. Zach Hardacre amongst them in conversation with Ollie Holmes. Let's get back to the three gentlemen that took you through the first 40 minutes. Standing by, Terry O'Connor, Barry McDermott, and the immaculately dressed Mark Wilson.
Cheers, Brian. Checks in the post. The home team won't be panicking. Twice in their three wins this season, they've had to come from a half-time deficit to win it, including against the champion St Helens, so they know what it takes. The question is, how much energy have they got left in the tank?
Do you know what? I think they'll be full of it, like Paul Rowley said, running down towards the fans. You look at them last week, if they come out 80%+, they've always got a chance with the threats that they've got. Zach Hardacre, Lachlan Lamb. I think you look at the Wigan Warriors side, they've been challenged the last 2 weeks against Salford, Huddersfield, managed to get the result, pushed all the way. But can the Lee fans bring them home?
Matt, big games often come down to the performance of those spine players, those key players in the Wigan ranks. How many times have we talked about French, Field, kicking game of Harry Smith? Well, if you flip that to the Lee side, Pape, Lachlan Lamb has to spearhead everything that goes through his hands, his feet, and get his side on the front foot. Zach Hardacre at the back, likewise.
It's a running repair needed there over on the far touchline side.
I tell you what, the local shops around Lee, anything that's got a leopard print on has gone down a treat, hasn't it? They might have had it in storage for 10 or 15 years. They brought it out as soon as they rebranded the club, and everyone's bought into it.
Say, Tez, at last you're in fashion.
Here we go then, back underway, Wigan. Looking to build on their lead. Can they do it? See the name of Gareth O'Brien bottom of your screen. He is out, remember, that head injury assessment. He's failed. So a bit of a reshuffle on the run for Lee.
Mark, I can see you looking at Tez thinking, where is the leopard print?
It's not on display. It's not on display.
It is not on display, I'll repeat it. I've just seen you shudder then. Just like
I'm wondering
else.
If they sell leopard print balaclavas. I might buy one. Wigan looking to clear their own end of the field here. To the 40 they go. So, last one. What if Wigan got Harry Smith kicking? Was on point first half. He's going high. This is another one of those swirling kicks. Zach Harnick is not going to get there. Wigan will. What can they do with the ball? They've got numbers here. They're going to kick. They're going to kick through. They need to get the ball down. And in the end, Briscoe grounds it. But did he ground it? Wigan think they've scored. Briscoe looked like he got it down, but
we
did
have
he?
No try.
Referee says
he's
no.
Confirmed the chasers, mate.
Big moment.
Offside,
let's check it.
10.
Okay, we've got no try, checking onside, offside. Okay, everyone to the right of the kicker is offside. Let's run it through from here, please. Make sure Smith doesn't put himself back onside. He doesn't. He never gets back involved in the play. And then he's touched by an offside player. Can we just run it back, please? Just back to the kick. Just so we get the mark. Yeah, okay. Thank you, I'm happy I've viewed the angles. Made by Zoom.
So, the chasers were offside, but we mentioned Harry Smith's kicking game a few times in that first half. If he carries on like this, Lee are in big trouble.
Yeah, Lee Leopards will look to get some pressure on Harry Smith, who, again, I said it in the first couple of minutes, looks to me like it's the first option to get into Harry Smith's hands, and that's why the referees are paid the big bucks. We're all distracted with the kick that came in from the replacement hooker, Brad O'Neill. We're distracted by, did Tom Briscoe get it down? Was it a try? Wasn't it a try? Well, it was a penalty because those kick chasers were offside.
They were, so that gives Lee a good chance, and that's a good touch finder as well. So having been under a bit of pressure early on second half, the Leopards have got it 20 metres away. Here they come now.
And listen to that roar behind the sticks there, just trying to pull them over that line.
All out centre field, dropped back underneath, driven in, they're inside the 10. Can Lee level things up here? They scored first in the first half. Ipape gets it away. They're going out wide here, a chance. Latelli going to be wrapped up. He's dragged back. Five away. Plays it far side to Charnley. Gets it away. Ball now centre field. It's popped up. Farrell happy to make the tackle in front of his own post. We're going to try to get more bodies to the near side, but they're going far side, Lee. They're trying to get to an edge. Ball's on the ground. It was kicked forward. Referee's going to come back for the first knock-on. So Lee can't make the most of their opportunity.
Well, local Lamb, he was trying to let the ball do the work. He was trying to skip outside. You could see, trying to skip outside of Kai Pearce-Paul. They definitely had the numbers that if Kai Pearce-Paul doesn't come up with this play and force the error, there's a certain try for the Leopards.
Well, we heard first half from the Wigan camp. Let's hear from the Lee Leopards camp. Tony Club is pitch side. Tony, what was said at the break?
Just being better in and around the ruck for us. We felt our ruck speed was too slow. They were winning the ruck and speeding the game up. And, you know, we can't keep letting them out their half to get up our end and attack. You know, you give Bevan and Jai too much space, they're going to burn you at some point. So we just need to be smarter down their end. Like where we are now, we just need to tighten up our D, get some numbers in, slow them down, so we're not giving them the opportunity to attack our end.
It's easy to say stop French in field, but how do you do it?
Like I said, keep them up here. When we're kicking down to them, sort of almost umbrella, you know, don't let Bevan sort of get across the field, and when we get hold of him, get into him. So same with Jai. You know, it's a bit different with Jai being in the half. So It's a good contest at the minute. I just feel like we can be better in and around the ruck.
Cheers. Thanks for that.
No worries. Thank you, guys. Cheers.
Here come Wigan with Farrell. Trying to put the squeeze on. They want more ball down the other end of the field. The Leopards not had it yet. They're putting pressure on Smith here, though, and French is going to have to kick. And that kick is charged down, but it's straight back into his hands. And French is away. And French now looking for support. He's got it on the inside with Wardle. Kicks through. Knocked down. Wardle gets it. And Wardle will score. Sensational try out of absolutely nothing. Just when Lee thought they got Smith under pressure. The charge down bounced away of Wigan.
We have a try.
And on the field, it's a try. Criminal moment in the Battle of the Borough. Has it gone Wigan's way?
Okay, can we? We've got a live call of try, we need to go back. Because it come from a kick, I need to check the wide angle, pause the ball on the foot, please, that's the process. Okay, pause the ball on the foot. Okay, yeah, we're okay playing on to this point. Okay, yeah, we're still okay playing on, let's keep going from here, on this angle, it's fine. Because I think there is then another kick. So there's no knock on, we're playing on to this point. We can pause the ball on the next kick, please. Okay, yeah, everyone is onside. So I think we can run it through to grounding now, please. It's touched by Hardacre in the air. It's then off the foot and the leg. No touch by Wardle. Takes possession and grounds the ball. I'm happy I've viewed the angles, I've made my decision.
Well, sometimes in sport, you need the bounce of the ball to go your way, and the brilliant Bevan French was quickest to react when the ball bounced his way, and Wardle, who was earlier in the sin bin, is now on the try scorers list, and Wigan lead by 8.
It's so cruel on Lee, but it's all class from Wigan. They put kick pressure. We talked about Harry Smith taking the time away from him. And when that kick goes in, just watch what the standoff Ben Reynolds do. He turns round, anticipating and trying to guess where the ball has gone. And when that charge down happens, the ball is picked up by one of the fastest players on the field. And then that's it, it's gone. Picks it up, you can see Reynolds facing the other way. I thought for a second he was going to drop the ball off and give it Toby King coming back on the inside. But Toby King's discipline makes him stay onside. And there you go, it's a wonderful finish from Jake Wardle.
Yes, mate. Speaking to the wrong ref.
Wardle's third try for Wigan. Smith looking to add the extras. Fine margins. Lee thought they had Wigan wrapped up. Wigan score. And Smith, though, can't add the extras. And it could be one of those nights. Smith groans. No problem for Wardle, though. Did so well to stay onside, but the reactions of French made the
try. Yeah, well, they did so well in that set. They restricted Wigan to 29 metres. And then, obviously, you get a bit of luck, you get a bit of skill. You got the effort from Wardle just to keep on chasing up. And like Barry said, it can be so cruel because Lee did everything well to get up, put pressure on. And Oliver Holmes, unfortunately, charges the ball down straight into the hands of Bevan French.
What you want to do in that point there is take time off. Paul Rowley, our studio guest, used the word spook. You need to spook the guy with the ball that's going to put the kick in. You don't want a late shot. You almost don't want to charge it down because it's unpredictable where that rugby league ball is going to bounce.
Well, Wigan got the bounce of the ball, and they were more than happy to finish off the job. They lead by 2 scores. Plenty to happen between now and the full-time hooter. And Wigan working their way up to halfway. Now a lead mentally after that blow. Wigan fans are in great voice here. High kick again. This is going to be contested for. Pressure arriving. Ball knocked forward though by Miski. It's a good job. They, I think there was a push as well there.
Jake Wardle was nudged off the ball, wasn't he?
Off the wall, mate. You clearly push him off the ball.
Jake Wardle sees a defender in front of him in Ben Reynolds, and he just obviously no finesse about that. Not allowed to do that. Ben Reynolds doesn't have to move. He doesn't have to change his angle, change his run.
Kick for touch is a good one. So, Lee. Start 40 off their own line. No immediate panic, still lots of time remaining, but most conscious they don't want to concede again now.
They need a good 10-minute spell, don't they, up the other end of the field, in front of their own fans. Obviously, behind on the scoreboard by 8 points. They can't afford to let Wigan be the next on the board. Seata again just looking to link up with Mulhern or play out the back. They decide to take the tackle. Oh, was there a bobble there?
There's a Pape. Puts it away to Lamb. Lamb moves the ball out. They're trying to get through, but Wardle again races up on the edge, cuts down the room. Nowhere to go for the Leopards at the moment. And Pape gets it away, carried forward. And they're 30 away. What have they got? They're going to go to the boot of Lamb. Lamb just pokes the kick through. Oh, it's fumbled. It's gone back. There's French, who was quick enough to touch it down. That was half a chance, but French again, the quickest to react when the pressure was on.
When you get the ball up this end of the field, and Lachlan Lamb can come up with players like that, build a bit of pressure, make Wigan feel uncomfortable. King couldn't get the ball. You could see the chase from O'Donnell putting pressure on Bevan French.
Wigan just getting a breather, letting the shot clock run down as much as they can. As the kick goes towards halfway, nice touch from Hardacre, gets it away. The Wigan chase, though, is a good one. First tackle made, 35 out.
Get a couple of big early carries here. Pick your man out, get over the top of him, play it quickly.
Kootboy did well to cling on to that. He wanted a set restart, he's not going to get one. Here goes Asiata now, gets it to Lamb. Nice movement from the Leopards, almost through. Great tackle, Pierce Paul. And now they're trying to pinch one from close in. No room there for Mbappe. Hardacre in at dummy half. Gets the ball to Asiata. Short they go again. Wigan spot that coming. There's no second phase. Last one. Which way do the Leopards go? Lamb is to the right. It's a slow play of the ball because the Kubowai has picked up a knock. They'll come to that right side. Little stab through the line. Was it played out? It's picked up. Is it going to be back to one? It is. So a chance for Lee here.
Here you go. This is their chance, the Leopards.
Mulhern leading the charge. 10 gone already, second half. Lee two scores behind. Now it'll go again. Pape trying to poach, he's close. Wow, he was
desperate.
Close.
He's desperate for a quick play of the ball, isn't he? He's lightning from dummy half. He just wants it and needs it to be a bit quicker. Well, your markers aren't quite set. There's a bit of space around that ruck.
Here now come the Leopards again. Holmes with a step, but they were ready for him. Can Lee break this Wigan defence? They go with Asiata. Lamb back on the inside to Hardacre. Again, the Wigan defence alert. Hardacre fighting, trying to wrestle his way to the line. He'll play it now a couple of metres away. Ball now, they're going to stab the kick through. It's going to be picked up on the line by Smith. And Smith is collected on his own line.
But a chance to build some pressure for the Leopards now. In their defence, Mbappe off the line. He's had a couple of goals with the ball. And he's rocked Wigan in defence as well. It's a point you made a moment or two ago, Tez. This North Stand here, energising.
Well, they're not cheering too much now. That's a great clearing run. Lovely offload by Wigan. They'll play the ball 40 off their own line, and now they're going route one, just trying to pinch the leaders downfield.
Looking for an offload again then, King.
Ball now working its way here now, is that man French with a dummy, going wide, gets it back inside, not backwards by Lee, French at the moment, everything he touches is turning to gold. And even when he makes a mistake, he gets the best of it.
Sorry, Mark, he shows the ball, doesn't he? Inside runner, and it almost fools the Leopards' defence. But Ed Chamberlain can't keep hold of this ball. He's just grasping, isn't he, Tom Briscoe?
He did well to recover then, Tom Briscoe, didn't he? He tried to hold him up, showed the ball inside. Tom Briscoe then just managed to get hold of him, but you know the fear in defenders when he gets that ball.
But it all came from the run. Brad O'Neill, the replacement hooker, while his side in the Wigan Warriors were under pressure, gobbled up 30 metres downfield, and that's the reason they're in this good field position.
Yeah, they've turned a bad situation into a good one. Morgan Smithies is back on, and he's got his hands on the ball now. O'Neill just pops it up. Wigan looking really now to land one flush on the chin of Lee. They're working it to the right-hand side. Here's Field. Field gets it away. They're trying to get it out. What a pass that was. Here's Paul with the offload, but Charlie makes the tackle that keeps the Lee line intact. Back to the middle they come. Wigan knocking on the door again. Centre field, they have it. O'Neill waits, gets it away to Smithies, moves it now to Smith, ball to French. French gets it away, checks in for Miski.
The Lee Leopards players under so much pressure, doing everything right. We're getting off the line and trying to force an error, but it's just a bit of class. A good ball from French and a good finish from Miski under some pressure. Players in motion, offering himself. You've got Harry Smith just keeping defenders honest by playing square and direct. They offload the ball as soon as they pull the defender into the space where they want to be. The outside man, I think it was Ed Chamberlain, decides to shoot in. And you shoot in trying to close the player down because you know you're under a bit of pressure.
Well, he knows Miski, doesn't he? He knows that his side had to withstand a comeback of sorts in the second half from the Lee Leopards. And doesn't he love scoring at this ground? Played for Lebanon in the World Cup and scored three times wearing his nation's colour. But the skill to catch and pass at the same time from Ben French was sensational.
We're used to the flying finishes. Sometimes you need a bit of brute strength as well, and Miski had the strength to get in. Tough kick this, but this would make it a three-score advantage. Smith from the sideline sends it, but he's pushed it wide, so it remains only 12. And Harry Smith's goal-kicking woes are just keeping Lee interested here.
It was nice hands, wasn't it? Wigan, again, even though they had to work, and it was skillful from Bevan French, but he was hard on his toil near their own line, and Brad O'Neill got them out of jail. It was an almost break, almost try from Bevan French prior to that, but they've gone from one side to the other in a couple of plays.
Lee Centurions then will, Lee Leopards, my apologies, will get us back underway. Wigan have got it back. Right, more team news then. Let's get down pitch side. Jenna Brooks.
Yeah, Mark, Ben Nkumbuwai has just limped off the pitch. He's gone straight down the tunnel. He looked like he was in a lot of pain. Looks a little bit like either lower leg injury or ankle injury, but I'll get an update for you in a moment.
More problems for the Leopards. They've given away a penalty.
They've got to be disciplined at this end of the field, haven't they? Trying to buy a little bit too much time, and the referee, Liam Moore, I think he's handled this game really well. He's allowed the players to express themselves. It's been played with a lot of passion. It's a noisy old stadium, and to our left, those Wigan fans now have found their voice.
They have. They can see their team are getting on top here. Physically and on the scoreboard. One another one quickly. Field gets it away.
Two.
Just over the halfway line. Some more injury woes for the Leopards. The Kubuai's gone off. They've lost Gareth O'Brien as well to that failed head injury assessment. Here goes Smith. Short pass to Farrell. Farrell backs his way in as he so often does inside the 20. Bevan French, the man of the moment. Has it. Gets it away. Here now is Smith again. Gets it away. Room for Field. Little step. Another step. Goes through the line. Jay Field. Oh, it's magical. It's brilliant. And it might just win the Battle of the Borough. Second for Field. That was out of the top draw. Wigan lead 22-6.
Well, Wigan, through Jay Field, what balance and acceleration they have within the back division here. Well, he's watched his good mate, Bevan French, come up with a couple of beauties in the last few minutes. He gets the ball, he's sliding across, he knows the defenders. And on that occasion, it's O'Donnell, can't keep his feet, he skips inside. Good footwork, and again, acceleration into the gap. In front of the Wigan fans, right under the black dot. And I don't think this game is dead and buried yet, but that might be another nail in the coffin.
Well, Matt Peake last week changed things when things weren't working. He moved Bevan French, he moved Jay Fields, and you have to say tonight it is proving to be the perfect option, isn't it, for Wigan?
Well, you can't buy that speed, can you? And he's done it a number of times in the year where he's moved Cade Cust into the nine position and had French and Field on the ball as much as possible. Nice easy one for Harry Smith in front of the Wigan fans. And that adds another 2 points to that scoreboard. But you look at the work that Harry Smith does when he gets hold of the ball there. He's looking up and he's eyeing three defenders. He's got a dummy runner that's outside of him. And you can see he goes at the line, engages three men. The dummy runner gets someone interested. O'Donnell then panics, realises that Jay Field's going to get the ball. So he chases hard, turns his shoulder. Jay Field spots it and he just comes back against the grain.
Mark, I take your point about the positional changes, but it's different. It's different and it's a different feeling to start the game as opposed to being moved into there partway through. Everybody's set. Everyone starts at the start line of the race at the same time. And you have to say, that spine of Wigan has been outstanding, hasn't it? Game management from Harry Smith, Jay Field and Bevan French with those final touches and the acceleration. Well, that's the difference for me.
He's the reigning Super League coach of the year, Matt Peake. I think he'll be feeling pretty pleased with himself tonight, so he should be. His side have come here ready for a battle. And they're serving it up to Lee, who at the moment have got no answers. Here come Wigan again, trying to punch holes up the middle. Lee looking a little bit tired now. As here the ball works its way to French. French gets it to Wardle. Wardle to Miski, kicked ahead. Good hands from Hardacre.
And isn't he lucky, Matt Peake, to have on his coaching staff somebody like Tommy Luluai, played at nine and scrum half all the way through his career, to lend his experience to those halfbacks, and then of course Sean O'Loughlin, who could play anywhere. He could play in a front row and he could play at standoff as well.
Pierce Paul makes a thundering tackle. Another busy week of Super League and NRL action, as you can see bottom of your screen. Don't forget an Easter rivals round in Super League, all six ties plus the opening of the Women's Super League, alive on Sky Sports. Can Lee do? We said they wouldn't panic at half time, but they're under some real pressure now.
Yeah, there'll be a different mindset now. One and 18 points behind, they need to be up here in that good ball earlier. But the way the Warriors are just chewing up the meters with some strong carries, nice and direct off the rope, making decent meters. Look at this, Miski. King will be putting his hand up here, targeting those same defenders, making those big fellas work extra hard.
And Lee brought Matt Davis onto the field. If Pape's having a break, Matt Davis is a different prospect at nine. Obviously, he can play in the back row, the former Warrington and London player.
Well, they are doing it tough, the Leopards. Remember, they lost Gareth O'Brien earlier on. Must have been Nakubuai as well, as Field is wrapped up over on the far side. There he is, and a brace on that knee would be very worrying. We hope the big fella's okay, but that doesn't look good, does it, for the Leopards. High kick, pressure incoming. The ball on the ground, picked up by Lee Charnley, trying to get away from his own line. What a place to turn it over. Half a metre. Oh, they're free. I think he's going to bring it back, actually, and say there was a knock-on, so they'll get a bit of a reprieve there, Lee.
I think it was Kai Pearce-Paul, wasn't he? He went up and challenged Zach Hardacre in the earth. Made him feel really uncomfortable. Really accomplished. Full-back. It's Toby King, actually, not Kai Pearce-Paul, that knocks the ball forward.
I'm surprised they haven't gone to that more. They've been very effective in other aspects, other facets of their game, but they've got some real size and height over on that right edge.
Oh, another problem here. Latelli buckled under the challenge, lost the ball. That didn't look great either, did it? Is it Pape, actually? Pape that went underneath there.
I think he just gets his ankle caught underneath the tackle, doesn't he? Still limping now. Trying to explode through. You can just see Brad O'Neill just pulls him down awkwardly.
Hopefully he's okay. But here come Wigan, looking to put this one to bed. They're a couple of metres away. O'Neill waiting. A set restart. Just what Wigan wanted. More time to build pressure. Leading by 18. All now centre field. Smithies finds Field, finds Farrell. Farrell bumping off, looking for a lazy defender. Ball's on the ground. Lee get it back. Referee gets a touch, so that will be a stopping play.
That knock on by Liam Moore.
No advantage. We've got the knock off. Where do you want it, boys?
Farrell, it was who lost it.
He came up with one in the first half, dislodged the ball, look at him, he just plants his feet, dips his head straight into Farrell around the ball.
I give you a compliment as well before. Scrumly ball, no advantage.
15 remaining. Lee's hopes dangling by a thread.
I don't, mate, shot clock off.
Wigan on their way to one Derby victory. Another huge clash next weekend, of course, when they take on St Helens. Over 20,000 tickets already sold for that one. You'll catch it all part of Rivals Round on Sky Sports Arena and Sky Sports main event on Good Friday.
Move, Liam! Hold!
It's Lee looking to work their way back in. They've struggled for meters, haven't they, at times?
I think they've looked at the scoreboard now and they're thinking, look, we're not having much joy at all. The Warriors, the way they're defending, they look short of ideas.
Here they are, trying to just poke up the middle of the field, trying to pinch some meters. There is Matt Davis. Last one, 40 away. Here's Lamb, he will go high. Can they get any kind of pressure? Hard anchors after Bevan French. French catches it.
Well, that's how you deal with him. As soon as he catches it, you've got to pouch him straight away. Zach Hardacre misses him, but he's kept by somebody else. Well, they're looking to get the line speed. They're nice and compressed here. Liam Byrne back onto the field. With a strong, strong defensive effort here from Apapi and Mulhern.
Well, they've done it tough with a couple of injuries going off, but Lee just haven't been able to match the power of Wigan at times as he kick over the top here. They're chasing it. Look at the pace. They might get it. Just Field just couldn't take it in. And is he injured? He's just gone down, holding the back of his leg. And I think he could be in a spot of bother here. And Jay Field, who made his Super League debut against Lee at Headingley when he got injured on that occasion, and he's down again. He was at full tilt, and just as he goes to the ground here, there, grabs the back of his leg.
He had some trouble with his hamstrings when he first arrived in the country, didn't it? He's just on the sideline with the physio taking a check. I'm sure they won't want to risk him at the back end of this game.
I think they've already taken him off, Barry. I think they've already got the sub on.
Matt, just going back to Lee Leopards and how they've had to reshuffle. Let's not forget Gareth O'Brien in the opening couple of minutes. So the shuffle that they had to do, I know that the lads in the studio thought it might bring a better balance to the side when they're on attack, but they haven't made enough metres coming away from their own line. They haven't created momentum, and that's been another one of the differences between these two sides.
This is better, though. Nice hands. Ball out to Charlie. Charlie dunks the ball back inside. That is Letelli. Letelli offloads it. Here's Davis. Powell trying to wrap him up. Well, if they're going to get something here, they're going to have to chance their arm.
Yeah, exactly. That's what's going to work for them. The power game's not working. They've got to throw the ball around and throw caution to the wind.
Here's Lamb. Tries to get it away to Chamberlain. Chamberlain tackled. Good sliding defence, and that will be the turnover. So with 12 minutes remaining, Wigan lead by three scores, but drama on both sides on the injury front, and I'm sure fans of St Helens will be at home wondering if Jay Field will be fit next week.
Look, nobody wants to see players injured, but I'll tell you what, if you're playing against Wigan and you see Jay Field or Bevan French go off, you're going to be pretty happy if they miss him for that big derby game next week.
Remember, no Kay Cust at the moment. Pete said they will find out more about his injury over the weekend. He's got a problem with a bulging disc in his neck. We wish him a speedy recovery, but Wigan might just be losing some key players. There is Kate Cust. Hopefully we'll see him out on the field sooner rather than later. As Wigan looking now to just calm this down. It was ferocious stuff in the first half. Here's Smith again. Smith taking on the line, pokes a kick through. Miskey's after it, but it's just going to beat him into touch. Well, Harry Smith has really stood up tonight for Wigan. I think he's had a great game.
Well, we said at the start of the game that he's got to be the one that manages it and controls all those last sort of players. When he gets the ball and he runs at the defence, the lead winger's got to come up. There's a bit of space created at the back, and he's just looking to try and get the kick right. Oh, he's forcing another error here.
Error. And Lee's hopes are evaporating.
And that's what comes off the back of a pressurised kick. You kick it off the field, they've got a set to bring it away. You're looking up, all you can see is Wigan jerseys in front of you. They're going to try and hit with some force, or Donald just can't quite take it. I think it's Ethan Navard that clocks the ball.
But he has a couple of defenders in front of him. I think Willie Iser. Well, that's his trademark, up quick. Shot clock off. And he steps off his left foot, O'Donnell, right into the teeth of two front rowers.
Well, Wigan wanted to play from the base of the scrum there, but the Leopards were out quickly. But here they are, the Warriors, looking for another try. And they're trying to power their way towards the line. A metre short. Here they are now. Byrne will have a carry. He's wrapped up, a metre short. Options everywhere here for the Warriors. They're going right. Smith with a ball over the top, a looping pass. Ball back to Pierce Paul. Tries to hold off Letelli. Charlie's in there. They'll wrap up the England international. Good effort that from Lee, but they need more of the same. We can get it to Smith. Smith gets it away here now. They'll poke the kick through. Should be dealt with by Briscoe. And Briscoe, happily for Lee, gets his hands on the ball.
I don't mind that. I know they still had tackles in the bank there, but the kicking game, the short kicking game, the little dab behind has been really good for the Warriors this evening. And yet again, the Leopards have to work all the way downfield. That's the reason they're throwing the ball, taking risks. What's that, 20 metres away from their own line?
Well, it might just have brought them a few more metres as Hardacre pounces on the offload. Looking over the 30. You just go back to that try after half-time when Jake Wardle got on the end of that Bevan French kick. It was a game-defining moment. Here now, though, come the Leopards. Here is Amon. Wraps up on halfway. Last one. Time ticking away. Pape finds Reynolds. Reynolds plays short. They need an offload. They get one. It goes behind Lamb. Dummy. Now the kick over the top. But guess who's there? Harry Smith. Brave. Down at the feet. The boots were flying. He was there to pick it up.
Yeah, he's been good. He anticipated that well, didn't he? Zach Hardacre. I think he's really led the troops, Harry Smith, in this game. I know I've mentioned him an awful lot, but he's been that dominant for me.
Third, move! Oh, this is Tom, hold, hold.
Oh, third. Wigan working downfield, a job almost done for them. It'll be a fifth win in seven. Smith, short pass to Farrell. Last one. Smith on the short side wants it and gets it. He's going to go high though, and Bevan French is after Hardacre here. Ball there to be fought for. Hardacre comes up with it this time and takes it well.
He called for it, Bevan French. Just went along, give Harry Smith a little tap on the shoulder, said kick the ball inside. I'm chasing.
Those two have had a good battle tonight, haven't they, underneath the high ball? Lee not giving up. They face Salford next weekend, another game that you'll see live on Sky Sports over the Easter weekend. Sure, Paul Rowley will have been having a close look at his old side tonight. You can see all six of the Super League games. So there's the crowd then, and it is a Super League record crowd here at the Lee Sports Village, 9,189. Credit to everyone that's turned out tonight. Maybe not the result that the majority of them wanted, but great to see a packed crowd. We had the band on before, and the game's not let us down either.
And it's felt like a sense of occasion, hasn't it? We went for a little walk, a little coffee, and we bumped into people all really excited about this evening. In a tremendous atmosphere.
This is Hardacre trying to get Lee on the board. Holmes is wrapped up, but a chance for a consolation. Tackle made, five away. The Leopards looking for a second score. Here's Asiata, gets it away to Lamb. They close him down. Great work from Pierce Paul. He came rushing in off the centre position there and got his man. They're attacking down that side again. Another tackle made. Last one. What have they got? The Leopards. Is there the faintest of hopes? A little kick over the top. Is there to be one? Oh, they couldn't get it down. There were Leopards in the shot. But the ball goes dead.
Desperation. They just can't quite get that. There's three lead players going for it. They can't get it.
Well, they're away here. They're away here from the restart. And it's Amos Miskey. He's got support. He didn't realise. He didn't panic. And Wigan once again, when they're put under any kind of pressure, is here now. Goes King, plowing a long furrow. Gets the ball away to Farrell. Farrell will just settle things down. There's no panic here for Wigan. They get the pass away. And they tackle five out. And that's the zero tackle. And Wigan now about to settle the Battle of the Borough. 10 out they are. And now they've got a penalty. And you've got to imagine they may well put some more points on the board from here.
They're not going to go for two, are they, Mark? Give them a goal with a ball. You can see that Lee Leopards player, is it O'Donnell, down on the ground. He's offside. He takes the risk and gets out. He knows he's got to make that tackle. But let the lads play with the ball, Mark.
OK, Brad. Let's go. Hit the line.
Well, here they go, looking for another try. They want one more just to send their fans home. Absolutely delighted. They'll keep it now. Little dummy. The forwards are fancying one here, aren't they? Here goes O'Neill. O'Neill gets it wide. Ball back on the angle. Pierce Paul just dumps it on the ground. It's going to be picked up over on that far side. Willie Iser going for the line. He's tackled five away. into the centre of the field. Shorrocks quickly wrapped up. Tackle made. Two remaining. The game won. The only thing in dispute is the winning margin. And here goes Smith. Ball over the top. They're queuing up for it. Almost got in each other's way there. And in the end, Wardle is wrapped up. Miskie will play the ball. Where do they go from here? Farrell to Smith. Again, I in a little grubber kick through the line. Here comes the chases! Try! Toby King grounds it! And it's a Derby Day victory for the Wigan Warriors. They lead Lee, who have been brave, but have been overpowered and outclassed. Wigan lead 28 points to 6.
You're right, Mark. I think Lee have been brave in this game, just beaten by that bit of class and power, especially in this second half. Toby King goes over, and what, yeah, when you watched Lee, they were desperate. They were working very hard for each other. The only thing that was going to break the defence was a kick, and it was a clever kick yet again from Harry Smith. He pulled up the defenders. Once he spots there's a bit of space behind, and Toby King has his hand up going for it, along with Sam Powell. He knows he's got to get the execution right. And King celebrates in front of those Warriors fans that have travelled the 8 mile from the stadium to come over and watch this game. And they're the ones that's going to end tonight with the bragging rights.
Well, they got the big try last week. This one not quite as important, but they'll enjoy it just like those Wigan fans are enjoying it. Tough night for the Leopards. They'll stay on 3 wins, and they'll learn lessons from this. Matty Peat's biggest worry tonight might be that potential injury to Jay Field. We'll find out more, I'm sure, post-match about that. Smith, I think, will be grateful this one's adjacent to the post. He sends it through, 30 points to 6.
There's been a number of good performers for the Wigan Warriors tonight, and he's definitely one of them. But it's been a magnificent team performance. There was a break from Miskie. He kept his composure, and Matty Peat, Thomas Lulalai, on his left, our right, they'll be delighted with what they've watched. It was a gorgeous kick that just bended back in field, and Adrian Lamb, well, the body language tells you, he's not entirely happy with what his side has done. They can't fault the effort that his side's put in, but they haven't been smart enough, they haven't been clinical enough, and they certainly haven't been up to the standard of their opposition.
No, but when you're a newly promoted side, wins are tough to come by. They've got 3 already in the opening 7 rounds. You know, it's not all doom and gloom, is it?
No, it's not. And the way that they played last week against Hull FC was absolutely outstanding. They tore them to shreds. But I do think that losing Gareth O'Brien really affected them early on. They needed those key players all on and all firing to have a chance.
The last half a minute we go. Wigan, who were behind early on. And since Bevan French opened the Wigan account, they've not looked back. Griffield's try had them in front at the break. Further tries from Wardle, Miskie, Field and Toby King. Now a chip over the top, and here's Bevan French. Is he going to kick for the corner? He is! Going to be a chance for Miskie! Another bit of magic from Bevan French.
Well, they've tried that a couple of times in the last 5 or 10 minutes. Brian Carney almost getting involved then. Well, he'd have dropped it if he'd have got anywhere near it. Carney. But high quality skill from the Wigan Warriors. Bevan French, he's given the whisper to Harry Smith. He's stayed onside, he's showed the discipline. He's got the acceleration and skill to catch it. And then the composure with that last kick to just dribble it into the path. Look at this, right foot, Miskie in the corner. It's absolutely sensational from Wigan. And that scoreline looks a little cruel for the Leopards. They have put a lot of effort in, but they've come up against a red hot Wigan Warriors tonight.
They have indeed. Matty Peake delighted. Tommy Lulawai the same.
We have to say, don't we, what the Wigan Warriors have given us access to as viewers and as fans. Matty Peake has been sensational, and they're leading the way on letting the fans, letting everybody who's got an interest in how players think, how coaches work. They're leading the way, the Wigan Warriors Club, and well done to them. Thank you for all that access and all that information.
Yeah. Liam Marshall, joint top try scorer coming into the weekend. Well, Abasmiski has got a double on his first appearance. He's gone over 200 metres tonight as well, giving his coach plenty to think about. Smith can't add the extras from out wide. It might only be a short journey home from the Lee Sports Village for the Wigan Warriors, but it's one that the players and the fans will enjoy. Smiles from young and old, because the Warriors came here for the Battle of the Borough. They were behind early on, they had a man in the sin bin, but they overcame that with a wonderful second half performance. Lee, not quite good enough tonight. They'll dust themselves down ahead of their game with Salford. Adrian Lamb with food for thought indeed. But Matty Peake, he looks quite happy. It's been a good night at the office for the Wigan Warriors. They've seen off their local rivals. It ends here, the Lee Leopards 6, Wigan Warriors 34.